Okay, walk past the camera. Everybody go.
Hey. Totally serious. Why did you
do? One thing about living in Burnett Hall is the line design, the absolute sturdiness of everything, and the safety equipment. As you can see here, this rail will support probably about 15 or 20 men. No problem at all.
Got it? Okay,
so
you got it, go!
Run. Hey, this is a fix,
go.
Not two
and
us!
Dick, where they go from here?
After they get the third lifesaver, they move out! Where, who? Go! Over here! Over here!
Water relay, right there!
Yeah, go!
all the people below. Costa Rica is the place I want to go. Did you hear us? Costa Rica is on my mind. It's the place where I'm bound most all the time. To the Lord of love, to the people below. Costa Rica is the place I want to go. Costa Rica, baby. Costa Rica, baby. Costa Rica, baby. Costa Rica, baby! Costa Rica, baby!
Old McBeldum had a team, E-I-E-I!
Oh.
And on that team he had a cheer, E-I-E-I!
Oh.
Old McBeldum had a team, E-I-E-I!
Oh.
Chipam Belly! Chipam Belly!
Sa!
Sa! Come on, Gawa!
Sa! Come on, Gawa!
We go, ha cha cha!
We go, ha cha cha!
All us brothers, sing a man G!
All us brothers, sing a man G!
Who might us you think are we?
Who might us you think are we?
Mata mata wa wa wa,
mata mata wa wa wa,
mata mata mukara,
mata mata mukara.
FIFA victory is our aim.
FIFA victory is our aim.
Watch the Koreans win the game.
Watch the Koreans win the game.
K-O-R-E-A, Korea.
Korea. Sa.
Champions for this year at 4,800 is the country of Germany.
Dedicate this song to our man Kevin Casey. Where is Kevin?
Yeah! Yeah, dude! morning I want to speak to the subject of authority. Authority for some people is a dirty word. Listen to what it says. Philippians, the second chapter, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God the Father. Every eye will know who I am. Everybody will come to recognition. Every tongue will have to confess that I am Christ the Lord. You are a gifted people. Someone came along and told you that Jesus Christ is Lord. And you said, I believe that.
Bethany, for those of you that don't know.
Hello.
There you go.
This used to be our quiet time. The kids love this better. Some of the dorms that the guys live in have a secret sister thing with their sister dorm. Today, in my mailbox, I got Mickey Mouse. This bag belongs to Pete Steele, box 585. And in it, first was a postcard that says hi on it. And it says, Pete, have a wonderful day. I'm glad you're my secret bro. God bless you. Your secret is this. But they spelled secret wrong. That's very correct. Jesus lives. Raised from the grave. Hold on. Okay. Jesus lives. Raised from the grave. Death to kill, eternal life to save. Now let's take a trip back in history and discover the man behind this victory. Christ descended up on earth through immaculate conception and the virgin birth. Obeyed his mom and dad, faithfully went to school. Faithfully went to school.
With Shavel, the sharpest razor in the world,
you can cut your own throat for all I care. You slob! Who do you think you are, anyway?
Little Red Riding Hood.
And then you suddenly appear before me.
TV program called Father Knows Best. It was a good all-American middle-class comedy. It was real funny. Well, Pete Rose, you know Pete Rose?
Yeah!
He's got a new TV program coming out in November. It's called Father Knows Best.
Take
I don't like your style, and I just can't understand your fate. Jeopardy?
with the Vice President of Academics, Deborah Wilson. You can choose our first category.
Social life.
Social life for 200 points. Go ahead and pull up the question where you can see it. The answer is, the only place on campus you can find Tootsie Roll Pops. Debbie Pohl.
Bookstore.
What is the bookstore's correct question? Diana Lehman.
Dating.
No, that is incorrect. I suppose that might be true, that's not correct.
And more people, we understand, will probably be checking in tonight for shelter and for a little bit of comfort. Things still a little chancy in Los Gatos. We will have more on the situation in Los Gatos and the effect of the great quake on Santa Clara County and the direct Bay Area in just a moment.
Stay with us.
Now, what that means, as far as we know at this time, is that the bridge will be completely shut down until all the repair work can be done.
Obviously, a crushed car caught between the sections there, and the damage is just incredible. People coming down, they're trying to pull that slab up and fix it. I don't know how many cars were caught in that section of the Bay Bridge. It looks like there are at least two.
Those who are without water, and only for those people. Now, this water alert means that if your water is restored sometime this evening, you need to boil it for 3 minutes before drinking it because of possible contamination. This is similar to what some people in Santa Cruz have been doing since last night. ACBEL is asking you to stay off the phone unless you have an emergency call to make. The company also asks that you refrain from calling the 611 repair line to report a problem or an outage. They say the company is well aware of the outages and they will find them and repair them.
Home video shows what it was like atop the bridge as the quake hit. A moment of sheer terror.
Only one customer at a time was served.
Fluid, hot dogs, Pepsi, six-pack root beer bread, chips.
Earth and dam reservoirs, though, in the mountains above the town held. It was the only good news Santa Cruz had.
I don't know if this isn't the big one. I don't know what would be left of this town if we got anything bigger than what we had.
The National Guard was activated to help police patrol the streets. County officials said damages here, where the earthquake started, would exceed $500 million. Roger O'Neill, NBC News, Santa Cruz.
From behind the police lines, you could see where buildings in the main business area were damaged. But the big jolt was reserved for another part of town. This is where people were still shocked, although, as so many people did last night, they were still expressing sympathy for pockets in the Bay Area where human lives were lost. Another crisis facing the people here is the specter of a severe water shortage.
When the tremor ended, most fans and ball players sat or stood, stunned by the suddenness and force of the shock.
I've lived here all my life, and it never scared me in an earthquake. That was the first one that scared me.
I'm just a little shook up by the whole thing, you know.
There was an orderly exit, some fans carrying chunks of concrete shaken loose by the quake.
Well, Doug, Maggie, the sun will soon set on the day after one of the biggest earthquakes to strike Northern California in many, many years. Santa Cruz County tonight is in the midst of a state of emergency. Damage is widespread, but perhaps hardest hit is the Pacific Garden Mall here in downtown Santa Cruz, much of which will ultimately have to be leveled. Here is a look at just some of the damage in downtown Santa Cruz. Daylight brought the people of Santa Cruz out into the streets to see what throughout the night they could only imagine. Much of the Pacific Garden Mall reduced to rubble. The cost measured in human lives and property damage that will no doubt run into the hundreds of millions of dollars.
We had within the county that we know of 5 confirmed fatalities.
As dogs went in search for still more victims, officials confirmed that one person died when part of the Hotel Metropole fell through the roof of Ford's department store. Another at the Santa Cruz Coffee Roasting Company. A third perished in a traffic accident. A fourth died of a heart attack. And a fifth in the collapse of a Watsonville bakery, one of at least 40 buildings known to have collapsed countywide. How are the people of Santa Cruz holding up? Fairly well under the circumstances, except that most appear to have ignored warnings to stock up on food and such just in case. This is the scene at virtually every grocery store in town.
But Highway 17 remains closed and reportedly will remain shut down. As you can see, it's quite major. It's not just a matter of clearing a few stones and...
Bible College Harvest Festival. And you know there, Mark, this is really an exciting festival event. There's some people who it is just great. It certainly is. And as you can see by the sign up there,
Aftershock.
We're
both going to be speaking to you for a while. Just probably describing kind of what's going on.
All these people dressed up in little trick-or-treat outfits.
And not one communist among them.
That's really great. We're really glad to see that no communists did show up. Oh, it's Rick and Shauna.
Help, Mike. Help.
I know who you are.
I say go. You get to open your bag and you get 15 minutes to use your mind, your creativity, to make a wonderful pumpkin. Okay? So everybody got it?
Bye! Bye, Sarah! Sarah!
track.
Grandma says it's a gift from you. If you can give it to all the other girls,
Why can't you give it to me?
Really, there was no film. I want to see the back muscles. What about your back muscles? The calves, the calves. Oh, yeah.
This is special.
Thank you.
Twilight.
morning, and some of our athletes did a tremendous job, and I know that you will be blessed by him. Let's give a warm Bethany welcome to Coach Bill McCartney.
You need to know that our locker room is in the north end of our stadium, and when you walk out the back door of the stadium, you go down a steep embankment about 75 yards. It opens up into three beautiful grass practice fields. If you enter at the far right where the gate is, that would be field one. Well, I'm all the way over on field three. We're 20 minutes into practice. I'm working with some offensive linemen in a drill, and student manager is over on field two, and he calls out to me, "Coach, you got a phone call." And I thought for a second, well, how absurd is this? And I said, "I don't take phone calls during practice." Loud enough for all the players to hear, of course. And so he said, "But coach, it's Sports Illustrated." I thought, you know, I better take this one. But the problem is the phone's way up there in the locker room. So I started across there. I thought, they want to apologize. That's why they're calling. They're calling to tell me that they're sorry they wrote all those mean things about us. But then as I got further across the last field and started up that embankment, I said, no, they're going to write about the fact that we got a heck of a football team. They want to do a feature story on us. But then as I got all the way up to the locker room and I was starting in toward my office where the phone was, I said, no, this article is going to be on you. But by the time I got to the phone, I was going to be on the cover of the next issue. So I picked up the phone and I said, hello, this is Bill McCartney. And a real sober voice came out the other end of the phone and said, Mr. McCartney, this is Sports Illustrated from New York. And I said, yes, sir. He said, Mr. McCartney, your subscription expired.
A story that was picked up by the press, a lot of pain came out of that. Coach, in front of the cameras, not knowing, I suppose, to some degree, affirmed that daughter, said, we love you, and in that vulnerability, the Lord has raised up some tremendous things. He's got to get out of here. He's got to go right now, so we're going to let him go, because in an hour and 15 minutes, he, at a coaching conference at Marriott Hotel in San Francisco, receives Kodak Coach of the Year Award for all Division I football coaches voted by his peers. And, Bethany sweatshirt for you. Here's one for your daughter. Here's a vase for your wife. And here's a Bethany Bruin for Timothy Chase.
Thank you. Yeah! I hear?
Santa's hand, straight up. Go!
Bop, 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 bop.
Yeah. problems of cataclysmic proportions. In the East Sector, sir, the damage is vast.
Is there something wrong with my abortion
clinics? Oh, no, sir. That's all wrong. We kill 4,000 unborn a day through, shall we say, surgical removal.
Good.
It's selective breeding. We eliminate human life in the name of convenience, like the Nazis and the Jews and with the government's approval.
Scottsvalley. And number one, it just seemed like the thing to do.
to claim it. I didn't know just what was wrong with me.
Bethany Bible College is missing.
Yes.
By the name of Norman Arneson.
All right! I've heard of you before.
I can pay you, Sam. We need you to find him. Will you take this case?
Well. Your aura is too much for me. Yeah, I'll take it.
Jim Pugh must MC. Everybody must do.
Why must you?
So, what I would like to challenge you all here tonight is something very important. I don't want the audience laughing. I don't want to perform, and I don't want the judges to gong. Let us all just sit for a moment and be.
Gong! Quiet time. Quiet time.
You mean you can't just be? Do you feel that you must do? Well, just be. Just relax and be.
Quiet time.
Yeah! You can't. I'm really disappointed.
You got get out of here.
There was an old man and he had an old sow. There was an old man and he had an old sow.
Well, perhaps one of the other professors.
Columbo.
One of the other professors in the biblical studies. Trent Bobo. He's a whole professor.
Volume.
It was my nephew, Edsel.
Well, there's a situation that's arrived. In case you're not aware of it, Professor Arneson is missing.
Oh, I was not aware of it. I would be more than happy to help you.
Yeah. Well.
Truett, are you going to be teaching hermeneutics in the fall? Oh, well, I would never think about doing something like that. Bobo is not God.
Ha ha ha!
Boy. I cannot.
They asked me what it
Get a close up of the candle. Get a close up of the candle. Yours now will look back on that candle and it'll mean a lot to us.
Go ahead.
Destiny.
by in a wink of an eye. Why do I feel the need to cry as we say goodbye? Everyone has a friend
they can count on.
Everyone has a pal
who is true.
But we all seem to agree that there are no friends like the ones we've made here at Bethany. Memories of these days
last a lifetime.
Memories of the last
will never fade.
Though times they can be hard, we still have no friends like the ones we've made here at Bethany. How many days did you wish that you could leave? How many times did you cry? But how many friends were there right by your side to help you grow? We hate to see you go. Everyone has a friend
they can count on.
Everyone has a pal
who is true.
But we all seem to agree that there are no friends like the ones we've made here at Bethany. Time goes by in a wink of an eye. Why do I feel the need to cry as we say